हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. वेलकम टू यू इन टुडेज माय क्लास. इन टुडेज क्लास वी विल स्टडी टॉपिक अबाउट द एरिस्टोक्रेसी एंड द न्यू मिडिल क्लास. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडेज क्लास. सो फर्स्ट, सोशली एंड पॉलिटिकली लैंडेड एरिस्टोक्रेसी वॉज द डोमिनेंट क्लास ऑन द कॉन्टिनेंट. द मेम्बर्स ऑफ दिस क्लास वर बाई अ कॉमन वे of life that cut across regional divisions. Their families were often connected by ties of marriages. This powerful aristocracy was, however, numerically a small group. The growth of towns and the emergence of commercial classes whose existence was based on production for the market. So, dear student, the aristocracy was the dominant class on the continent politically and socially. They owned state and property both in countryside and town houses. So, I already explained. The members of this class were united by a common way of life that cut across regional divisions. They owned state in the countryside and also townhouses. They spoke French for purpose of diplomacy and in high society. Their families were often connected by ties of marriage. This powerful aristocracy was, however, numerically a small group. The majority of the population was made up of the peasantry. To the west, the bulk of the land was farmed by tenant and small owners, while in Eastern and Central Europe, the pattern of land holding was characterized by vast estates which were cultivated by serfs. Industrialization began in England in the second half of the 18th century, but in France and part of the German states, it occurred only during the 19th century. In its wake, new social groups came into being, a working class population and middle class made up of industrialists, businessmen and professionals. It was among the educated liberal middle classes that ideas of national unity following the abolition of aristocratic privileges gained popularity. So, students, this paragraph meaning is, in western part of Central Europe, the growth of industrial production and trade meant the growth of towns and the emergence of commercial classes whose existence was based on production for the market. Industrialization began in England in the second half of the 18th century, but in France and part of the German state, it occurred only during the 19th century. In its wake, new social groups came into being, a working class population and middle class made up of industrialists, businessmen, professionals. In Central and Eastern Europe, these groups were smaller in number till late 19th century. It was among the educated liberal middle classes that idea of national unity following the abolition of aristocratic privileges gained popularity. So, I hope you understood. Industrialization began in England in the second half of the 18th century. New social groups came into existence, a working class population and middle classes made up of industrialists, businessmen, doctors, teachers and other professionals. So, students, in this chapter, next we will study next topic, what did liberal nationalism stand for? So, first, in early 19th century, Europe were closely allied to the ideology of liberalism. The term liberalism derives from the Latin root liber, meaning free. Liberalism stood for freedom, for the individual and equality of all before the law. It emphasized the concept of government by consent, a constitution and representative government through parliament. So, dear student, the term liberalism means free. For the new middle class, liberalism stood for freedom, for the individual and equality of all before the law. In France, the right to vote and get elected was granted exclusively to property-owning person. So, ideas of national unity in early 19th century, Europe were closely allied to the ideology of liberalism. The term, I also read this sentence, the term liberalism derives from the Latin root liber, meaning free. For the new middle classes, liberalism stood for freedom for the individual and equality of all before the law. Politically, it emphasized the concept of government by consent. Since the French Revolution, liberalism had stood for the end of autocracy and clerical privileges, a constitution and representative government through parliament. 19th century, liberal arts also stressed the inviolability of private property. Yet equality before the law did not necessarily stand for universal suffrage. Suffrage means the right to vote. You will recall that in revolutionary France, which marked the first political experiment in liberal democracy, the right to vote and to get elected was granted exclusively to property-owning men. The right to vote and to get elected was generated exclusively to property-owning men. Men without property and all women were excluded from political rights. Women and non-propertied men and women organized opposition movements demanding equal political rights. The abolition of state-imposed restrictions on the movement of goods and capital. A merchant traveling in 1833 from Habsburg to Nuremberg to sell his goods would have to pass through 11 customs barriers and pay a custom duty of about 5% at each one of them. Obstacle to economic exchange and growth by the new commercial classes, who argued for the certain of a unified economic territory allowing the unhindered movement of goods, people and capital. The Union abolished tariff barrier and reduced the number of currencies from over 30 to 2. So, men without property and women were excluded from this right. In the economic sphere, liberalism stood for the freedom of market and the abolition of state-imposed restriction on the movement of goods and capital. In 1834, a custom union or Juvenalien was formed at the initiative of Prussia and joined by most of the German state. The union abolished tariff barrier and reduced the number of currencies from over 30 to 2. So, dear student, we read men without property and all women were excluded from political rights. Only for a brief period under the Jacobins did all adult males enjoy suffrage. Suffrage means, suffrage means the right to vote. However, the Napoleonic Code went break to limited suffrage and reduced women to the status of a minor, subject to the authority of fathers and husbands. Throughout the 19th and early 20th centuries, women and non-propertied men organized opposition movement demanding equal political right. Okay, so in the economic sphere, liberalism stood for the freedom of markets and the abolition of state-imposed restriction on the movement of goods and capitals. During the 19th century, this was a strong demand of the emerging middle classes. Let us take the example of the German-speaking regions in the first half of the 19th century. Napoleon's administrative measures had created out of countless small principalities, confederation of 39 states. Each of these possessed its own currency and weight and measures. Merchants traveling in 1833 from Habsburg to Nuremberg to sell his goods would have to pass through 11 customs barriers and pay a custom duty of about 5% at each one of them. Duties were often levied according to the weight of measurement of the goods. As each region had its own system of weights and measures, this involved time-consuming calculation. The measures of cloth, for example, was the L, which in each region stood for a different length. An L of textile material bought in Frankfurt would get you 5.7 centimeter of cloth in Mainz, 55.1 centimeter in Nuremberg, 65.6 centimeter in Fehrenberg, 53.5 centimeter. Such conditions were weaved as obstacles to economic exchange and growth by the new commercial classes, who argued for the creation of a unified economic territory allowing the unhindered movement of goods, people and capital. In 1834, a custom unions or Jullerin was formed at the initiative of Prussia and joined by most of the German states. The union abolished tariff barrier and reduced the number of currencies from over 30 to 2. The creation of the new network of railways further stimulated mobility, economic interest to national unification. A wave of economic nationalism strengthened the wider nationalist sentiments growing at the time. I hope you all understood today's topic. Next topic of this chapter we will study in our next video. Thank you for watching.